pleasure of inviting on stage our other dignitaries to join us. We have 28 stalls exhibiting here today, among which 16 export promotion councils have come forward to exhibit their products, to promote export in the state and to motivate MSMEs to become an exporter. 5 more industry associations are exhibiting here, along with 1 testing laboratory and 1 training institute. And we would also like to share that DGFT is setting up on-spot IEC registration facility. We would request our exporters, our future entrepreneurs, to make the most of this opportunity post this inaugural session. The event aims to create a space and opportunities that facilitates cordial meetings of exporters with policymakers, industry players and export facilitators. The Export Carnival is planned with activities that guide exporters with international opportunities for the local produce. Interventions being taken by the government for the benefit of traders, meet and share success stories of leading manufacturers and virtual connect with foreign embassies. This most definitely then is a step forward towards a more powerful, prosperous and peaceful India. And we're so glad that this is happening in the presence of you all, our esteemed audience. Thank you to each one of you for joining us as we embark on this journey of making Andhra Pradesh a rising economic force. Please give us a few moments as our Honorable Chief Minister takes a tour of the Experience Center and the exhibition and stalls. Ladies and gentlemen, for the duration of the inaugural event, may we request you all to kindly switch off your mobile phones or keep them on silent mode. Please help us maintain the decorum of this event. Thank you. Thank you. And after having a tour of the experience center, we now witness our Honorable Chief Minister personally engaging with the exhibition stall representatives. Ladies and gentlemen, while our Honorable Chief Minister makes his way to the stage, may I extend a very warm welcome and kindly invite on stage Shri Peddireddy Ramachandra Reddy Garu, Honorable Minister for Panchayat Raj and Rural Development, Mines and Geology, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Shri Kursala Kannababu, Honorable Minister for Agriculture, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Shri Perni Venkatramaya, Honorable Minister for Transport, INPR, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Shri Kodali Shri Venkateshwar Rao, Honorable Minister for Civil Supplies and Consumer Affairs, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Shri Vellam Palli Srinivasa Rao, Honorable Minister for Endowments, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Shri Ayodhya Rami Reddy, Member of Parliament, Rajya Sabha, Padma Shri BVR Mohan Reddy, Founder Chairman and Board Member, Sciend, Shri Mr. Cab Dongli, Chief Administrative Officer, Kia Motors India Limited, Shri Adyanath Das, IAS, Chief Secretary, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Shri S. Suresh Kumar, IAS, Joint Secretary, Ministry of Commerce and Industry, Government of India, Srimati Poonam Malakondaya, IAS, Special Chief Secretary to Government, Agriculture, Horticulture, Fisheries and Sugar, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Shri JVN Subramaniam, IAS, Commissioner Industries, Commerce and Export Promotion, VC and MD, APIIC and CEO, APEDB, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Shri Tallari Rangaya, Member of Parliament, Lok Sabha, Shri Dharmana Krishnadas, Deputy Chief Minister, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Srimati R. Bhagya Lakshmi, Honorable Mayor, Vijayawada Municipal Corporation, and Shri Arvind Goenka, Chairman, the Plastics Export Promotion Council of India. May I also take the pleasure of inviting on stage Mr. Mettu Govind Reddy, Chairman, APIIC. Sir, please join us on stage. We're also joined by Sri Kotagiri Sridhar Garu, Member of Parliament, Lok Sabha. Now, ladies and gentlemen, as our chief guest for today, our Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, joins us on stage. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a warm round of applause for our chief guest, Sri Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy, Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. We're also delighted to extend a very warm welcome to Sri Meckapati Gautam Reddy, Honorable Minister for Industries and Commerce, Infrastructure and Investments, IT, Skill Development and Training, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Peddi Reddy Ramachandra Reddy, Honorable Minister for Panchayat Raj and Rural Development, Mines and Geology, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Kursala Kanababu, Honorable Minister for Agriculture, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Perni Venkatramaya, Honorable Minister for Transport, INPR, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Kodali Sri Venkateshwar Rao, Honorable Minister for Civil Supplies and Consumer Affairs, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Vellampalli Srinivasa Rao, Honorable Minister for Endowments, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Ayodhya Rami Reddy, Member of Parliament, Rajya Sabha, Sri Adityanath Das, IAS, Chief Secretary, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Padma Shri BVR Mohan Reddy, Founder Chairman and Board Member, Sciend, Mr. Cab Dong Lee, Chief Administrative Officer, Kia Motors India Limited, Srimati Poonam Malakondaya, IAS, Special Chief Secretary to Government, Agriculture, Horticulture, Fisheries and Sugar, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri S. Suresh Kumar, IAS, Joint Secretary, Ministry of Commerce and Industry, Government of India, Sri Javian Subramaniam, IAS, Commissioner Industries, Commerce and Export Promotion, BCN MD, APIIC, and CEO, APEDB, and Sri Arvind Goenka, Chairman, Flex Council. And as they now light the ceremonial lamp, which is the lighting of the lamp is considered as a symbol of auspiciousness, prosperity and abundance in Indian tradition. Light brings brightness with it and removes the darkness. Light is what makes it possible to see things clearly. It's only with the arrival of light that darkness disappears. A deep-rooted Indian tradition, and we have our Honorable Chief Minister and other dignitaries doing the honors. Thank you very much. May we please request all our dignitaries to occupy their seats on the dais. Requesting you all to kindly take your seats, ladies and gentlemen. Moving ahead, Andhra Pradesh is a resource-rich state with easy access to ports, talented young and skilled manpower. This vibrant state offers a plethora of opportunities to investors. The state government is committed to provide the best-in-class infrastructure and end-to-end handholding support for building a conducive industrial ecosystem. Allow us to share an audiovisual about the government's initiatives of infrastructure-led export growth. Can we have the AV, please?
Andhra Pradesh, India's most progressive state with abundant natural resources and skilled workforce. Under the dynamic leadership of the Honorable Chief Minister, Andhra Pradesh is moving ahead with boundless enthusiasm towards sustainable development and inclusive growth. With the longest coastline of 974 kilometers on east coast of India, Andhra Pradesh is located at a geographically advantageous location, giving access to huge South Asian and Southeast Asian markets.
And I foresee a great hope for not only the state of Andhra Pradesh, but also like-minded companies from all over the globe to come over to set up their shop in India, and especially in Andhra Pradesh.
Andhra Pradesh is pioneering the model of infrastructure and corridor-led industrial development. Andhra Pradesh is the only state with three industrial corridors, which are Vizag to Chennai Industrial Corridor, Chennai to Bangalore Industrial Corridor, and Hyderabad to Bangalore Industrial Corridor. In Koparthi, Kadapa, as part of VCIC, we are developing YSR Jagananna Mega Industrial Hub and YSR AMC with best-in-class infrastructure facilities like power, water, CETPs and STPs. As part of CBIC, Krishnapatnam node is being developed as greenfield industrial node in an area of 12,944 acres. Eight new fishing harbors along with processing facilities are being developed. An enhanced trade through a strong port infrastructure has given a boost to the state's economy. The current port capacity of 253 million metric tons is set to double in the next 5 years. The state is well connected through ports, airports, railways, and a rail network of 3,822 kilometers and national highway network of 6,913 kilometers. Currently, there is one major port at Visakhapatnam, four non-major ports, and three new ports are under development. There are presently seven operational airports and two under construction. With $16.8 billion of export, Andhra Pradesh ranks number four in exports from India. The state contributes more than 46% of India's marine exports, pharma, metals and cereals as other top exports. Honorable Chief Minister's vision is to double the state's export contribution from 5% to 10% by 2030. With the proactive steps taken by the government, the state moved forward from 7th rank to 4th rank. A dedicated strategic plan is designed to establish Andhra Pradesh as a leading export hub in the country. Promote value addition, upgrade institutions and infrastructure, streamline processes, harness human capital. The government of Andhra Pradesh has designed a slew of interventions to unlock new markets and promote value addition. We aim to promote districts as export hubs for identified products. We will strengthen linkages with external agencies in target markets. We aim to reduce cost of logistics to less than 10% of GSDP in line with best-in-class global destinations. Industry is being supported with best-in-class policies, providing tax reimbursements and production-linked incentives. A dedicated desk in YSR AP1 is being formed to support small exporters. Andhra Pradesh is strengthening its ease of doing business the reduced cost of doing business and risk of doing business, thriving trade and commerce, best-in-class policies, skilled labor, stable government, transparent administration, we have it all. Under the guidance and the vision of our Honorable Chief Minister, Sri Jagan Mohan Reddy, Andhra Pradesh is poised to create new benchmarks in industrial development through inclusive growth.
A simple motto that we follow at Andhra Pradesh is, you grow, we grow.
Andhra Pradesh, where abundance meets prosperity.
Thank you for your attention, ladies and gentlemen. And just to reiterate, in the last 2 years, moving from 9th position in exports to 4th position, and with all your support, this long journey will be culminated into easy steps. Moving forward, ladies and gentlemen, I now invite Sri Adityanath Das, IAS, Chief Secretary, Government of Andhra Pradesh, to deliver the keynote address. Can we please welcome him with a warm round of applause?
Good morning to one and all. I welcome Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu. I welcome Honorable Ministers, Sri Peddi Reddy Ramchandra Reddy Garu, Sri Mekapati Gautam Reddy Garu, Sri Vellampalli Srinivas Rao Garu, Sri Kodali Venkatesh Rao Garu, Sri Penni Venkatramaya Garu, Kurusala Kannababu Garu, Honourable Members of Parliament, MLAs, MLCs, Padma Shri Shri BVR Mohan Reddy Garu, Joint Secretary Government of India Suresh Kumar Garu, Special Chief Secretaries, Principal Secretaries, leaders from industry and export houses, ladies and gentlemen. I am honoured to address you all at this exemplary event taking place after almost a gap of 2 years in this format. Vanija Utsavam 2021 as part of the Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav commencing the 75th year of Indian independence. This event, that is Vanija Utsavam, is being organized at the state level for the next 2 days and at the district level during the week. Through this event, we wish to give an overview on the state government's vision for industrial progress. The state government is investing in infrastructure to attract investments and spur growth. Infrastructure, industry, trade form an interdependent chain of cause and effect. Superior infrastructure attracts investments and spur trade. Further, increased trade would also signal positive atmosphere and attract investments. This positive reinforcement would again culminate into increased spending on infrastructure, thus locking in a virtuous growth cycle. Another goal of the event is to serve the needs of exporters and aspiring entrepreneurs. We have designed various sessions, experience areas, and product exhibitions to give a bird's eye view on the opportunities and necessary process for exports in Andhra Pradesh. We also have representatives from several export outfits, councils, industry associations who can help the prospective exporters to understand their sector of interest. Tomorrow we have an interaction with Indian missions abroad to give a flavor of on the opportunities available in various countries abroad. This will be followed by a sector-specific mission on medical technology in Andhra Pradesh. We're also having an award ceremony felicitating exporters and industry champions contributing to the state economy. As we have just seen in this short film, the advantages Andhra Pradesh has, a land blessed by two rivers and a long coastline. As you're aware, the state of Andhra Pradesh is a geographically advantageous location, giving access to huge Indian market and connecting to Southeast Asian markets. We are well connected by road, rail, and airports. The government is investing on infrastructure to unlock efficiencies and enhance opportunity. Andhra Pradesh is blessed with abundant mineral resources, agriculture base, and surplus electricity. The state has a good industrial base in pharma, electronics, food processing, textiles, and automotive setup over several decades. The state has been bagged with 19 GI tags, including Guntur chili, Kalam kari saris, Banganpalli mangoes, Araku coffee, Kondapalli toys, and Bobili veena. The government and the leadership of our Honorable CM, Sri YS Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, is focused on to reduce the cost of doing business and risk of doing business so that the state of AP becomes a globally competitive destination for trade, investment, and commerce. We are also undertaking reform across the departments for eliminating and reducing the compliances which have an adverse impact on time and cost of business. 372 burdensome compliances have been identified, of which 288 burdensome compliances have been reduced, and another 33 burdensome compliances related to state acts would be repealed or amended in coming days. Andhra Pradesh has skilled manpower with over 500 plus ITIs, 300 plus polytechnic colleges, 450 plus engineering colleges, about 400 management institutions, 100 plus pharmacy colleges. Skill development is one of the main focus areas of this government. We are establishing 30 skill colleges with an investment of almost over 1,300 crores and industry linkages to train and make the students industry ready. As you heard our Minister for Industry saying, come and grow with us. So please come to the land of AP, the land of two rivers, Godavari, Krishna, and long coastline. Come, do business, and grow with us. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Das, for giving us a bird's eye view and a big picture of what this state can offer. Moving ahead, may I now invite Sri Meckapati Gautam Reddy, Honorable Minister for Industries and Commerce, Infrastructure and Investments, IT, Skill Development and Training, Government of Andhra Pradesh, to address the audience.
His Excellency, the Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri YS Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, to my cabinet colleagues, to the Member of Parliament, Rajya Sabha, Sri Ayodhya Ram Reddy Garu, Padma Shri B.R. Mohan Reddy Garu, founder Scient Technologies, to fellow bureaucrats, foreign embassy officials, the industry leaders participation, and the association participating in today's event. Let me extend a very warm welcome to all the speakers and the guests from all over the country who have come here to share their knowledge and the vast experience. It is my distinct honor and pleasure to host such esteemed guests today at the Vanijya Utsavam, the Export State Carnival of Andhra Pradesh, jointly organized by the Department of Industries and Commerce, Andhra Pradesh Economic Development Board, and also the Plastics Export Promotion Council of India and the CII. Reaching far inland from the fertile deltas of the Godavari and the Krishna rivers to the semi-arid Deccan Plateau, Andhra Pradesh has embarked on a journey of consistent growth. The state has been rated as the top state in the country for ease of doing business by the World Bank, offering a robust industry infrastructure, first-class connectivity, and a skilled workforce, making it a globally competitive investment destination. As part of the Azad Ka Amrit Mahotsav, to celebrate and commemorate 75 years of progressive India and the glorious history of its people, culture, and achievements, the Departments of Commerce is organizing the Vanijya Sapt from 20th to 26th September 2021, highlighting the role of exports in the economic growth of India. The two events organized by the Government of Andhra Pradesh to showcase our exports and our potential during this week would be the Vanijya Utsav, that is today and tomorrow, and an exporters conclave at the district level by the district industry centers from 24th to 26th September 2021. Today we have a participation of over 600 manufacturers and exporters in the presence of the Indian missions, officials from the central and the state government, and the export councils. The clarion call by the Honorable Prime Minister of India, Atmanirbhar Bharat, in one such bright spot to stimulate a self-reliant India and empower an ecosystem that will allow Indian companies to completely and compete effectively globally, thereby strengthening our export stature. As nations trace the path of recovery, there's a growing demand for high quality, new products, and a shift away from a reliance on a single source supply chains. There's no time like now, when the role of government becomes significant to work hand in hand with the Indian missions, exporters, export councils, and the industry associations in ensuring a high quality and a reliability of exports to global markets. In this evolving world, where we are seeing the time between innovation to incubation to production is being cut drastically, my thoughts go out to a book written by Adam Grant, Think Again, that in today's world, the power of knowing what you don't know will be the actual driving force that the nations and the leaders should strive for. Which brings me to the lessons we can draw from the growth path, followed by the other countries which grew over time into wealthy nations. If you look at the economic history, the Asian countries of Japan, South Korea, and Taiwan have grown rapidly on the strength of their exports. For example, it is not out of place to mention that Taiwan, which by area is one-fifth of our state, contributes as much as $330 billion to the world economy, which is greater than the Indian exports. This year, our Honorable Prime Minister has set a target of $400 billion for our exports, and we can clearly see from our Taiwan's example that the potential for this India is much higher. And to realize this potential, right infrastructure and enabling policies are the cornerstones. Our Honorable Government, led by our dynamic Chief Minister, Shri Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, has a very strong focus on improving our exports. In fact, he has given us a mandate by 2030 that we double our exports from the present status. So therefore, we are developing an exports-led infrastructure with upcoming ports, airports, roads and rail connectivity to the hinterland to drastically reduce the cost of logistics and make our exports scalable. Some of the key takeaways from this event are: this event in its true self will act as a curtain raiser to achieve the target of doubling the exports by 2030, where the existing and prospective exporters will see an insight into the state's potential and its intrinsic value to boost export trade. The Andhra Pradesh Experience Center is set up on the theme Infrastructure-Led Industrial Development and Trade, in which you will experience the development of export-led infrastructure and understand the potential, the global opportunities to diversify export basket and find new markets. You'll also be able to participate in insightful panel discussions on policies and interventions taken by our government in collaboration with the Government of India, the Indian and the Foreign Missions, and the Export Promotion Councils. Before I conclude, we all also know that the COVID-19 pandemic has disrupted the lives and sent shockwaves through the global economy. People are worried about their lives and livelihoods as companies rebuild and restructure for the next normal. Policymakers across the world are looking for ways to contain the spread of this virus while limiting the economic fallout. And this is a truly global crisis, as the virus does not stop at borders. Many of us are hopeful that the nascent signs of recovery that are appearing in some of the economies most severely affected by this economic downturn do not falter, and that the world economy can resume a reasonably robust and a stable growth plan. From a collaborative approach undertaken by the government to promote strong linkages while establishing clear policy standards to business reinnovation and re-engineering to cross the metaphorical chasm and embark on a journey of explosive growth to expand to new markets. Global cooperation and multilateral coordination is essential to accomplish this target. The government of Andhra Pradesh, under the leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister, Sri Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, has the will, and you have the power to realize the potential, the true potential of Swarna Andhra Pradesh. Please join us in realizing the potential of the state by harnessing the entrepreneurial spirit and pioneer the new wave of growth. Thank you, and Jai Hind.
Thank you very much, sir. Robustness, connectivity, consistency, and skilled workforce, words which go hand in hand with this vibrant state of Andhra Pradesh, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, sir, for giving us a sneak preview of what Vanajya Utsavam 2021 entails for all of us. May I now request Sri Arvind Goenka, Chairman, the Plastics Export Promotion Council of India, to address the audience. Can we please welcome him with a warm round of applause?
Good afternoon, Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy Ji, Sri Mekapati Gautam Reddy, Honorable Minister for Industries and Commerce, Infrastructure and Investments, IT Skill Development and Training, Government of Andhra Pradesh, all Honorable Ministers of Andhra Pradesh on the dais, Sri Adityanath Das, IAS Chief Secretary, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Suresh Kumar, Joint Secretary, Ministry of Commerce, Government of India, other dignitaries present for today's function, my fellow exporters, industry leaders from Andhra Pradesh, government officials, and other stakeholders. On behalf of the Plastics Export Promotion Council, it's my honor and privilege to stand before you today on the august occasion of celebrating India's 75th year of independence during the Vanijya Saptah as part of the Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. We are delighted to be working in synchrony with the extremely proactive and vibrant government of Andhra Pradesh under the able leadership of Honorable Chief Minister Sri Jagan Mohan Reddy Ji. We at Plex Council are also extending our participation under the guidance of the Department of Commerce, Government of India, in showcasing the economic growth of the state of Andhra Pradesh, especially promoting district-wise export achievements at Vijayawada today. We are certain that this event, based on the theme of showcasing India as a rising economic force, has enabled exporters to explore new businesses and trade avenues, highlighting the potential of exports from Andhra Pradesh. The event has been orchestrated such that there are industry-related brainstorming sessions over the next 2 days, and special impetus is laid in showcasing focused export products from Andhra Pradesh to the world. My congratulations to the Honorable Chief Minister and the entire team for this great show today in promoting the exports from the state with an appropriate agenda of involving the Indian missions abroad, which has helped pave the way for more export opportunities from the state. Friends, I thank the Department of Commerce for nominating and trusting Plex Council to assist the Government of Andhra Pradesh professionally in building up the event to that of an impeccable international standard. Plex Council is the apex body of plastics exporters and represents 2,700 members across the country. Established in 1955 by the Government of India, it has been assisting plastics exports for over 65 years. The Council has been actively engaging with the plastics industry and helping them in growing their business under the guidance of Department of Commerce, Government of India. Towards this end, the Council has been helping members participate in international trade fairs and organize buyer-seller meets at subsidized rates with assistance from the Department of Commerce. It assists especially the MSME units to enter the export market by helping them complete all registration formalities, and it introduces them to buyers in specific markets through exhibitions and B2B meets. Plex Council also helps its members and the plastic industry as a whole by representing their issues to various government ministries and departments at state or at center, so that manufacturing units remain competitive and continue to boost the plastics exports. It also collects data and feedback from the industry groups on behalf of the government, which helps in policy formulation. Friends, thanks to the efforts of Government of India and the exporters member, presently India's exports are valued at $10 billion. India's plastics exports, are valued at $10 billion. Value-added plastics exports comprise the largest share at $6.1 billion, followed by raw materials at $3.3 billion. Plex Council also represents human hair exporters, value of which is approximately $400 million. Friends, India's plastics imports are higher than exports. In 2020-21, our plastics imports stood at $14.6 billion. Raw materials itself comprised the largest share at $9.8 billion, followed by value-added plastics at $4.8 billion. Which clearly show that there is a strong need to boost polymer production capacity to make India Atmanirbhar in plastics. The proposed Vizag Kakinada PCIPR park will strongly address this national issue and boost exports of plastics from the state. Today, India's plastics products are exported to 200 plus countries across the globe, but have a very small share in the global exports, and we at Plex Consul are poised to improve our share significantly over the next few years. Currently, Europe is the largest destination for plastics exports from India and represents 23% of our exports, followed by North America 18%, Northeast Asia 15%, WANA region 13%, Africa 10%, South Asia 7%, and ASEAN 6%, among others. I am glad to inform you that Plex Consul is active in Andhra Pradesh with a plethora of plastics and human hair exports from the state. The area of export is thriving, as already established by seasoned exporters who are exploring brighter vistas and opening up new avenues for this commodity. In 2020-21, Andhra Pradesh reported plastics and human hair exports of US$181 million. Andhra Pradesh is among the top five exporters of plastic raw materials in India. In value-added plastics, major items being exported by Andhra Pradesh include plastic sheets and films, medical disposables of plastics, optical frames and lenses, and pipes and tubes of plastic. Andhra Pradesh is the second largest exporter of human hair from India. I am sure this Vanijya Mahotsav, which is specifically targeting exports, will encourage several plastic manufacturers in Andhra Pradesh to venture into plastics exports. I would request delegates and manufacturers to visit the Plex Consul booth in the exhibition for further information about how to start exports and how it can be beneficial for their business in the long run. Friends, noteworthy is also the setting up of the Export Experience Arena by the AP government, designed at this event, that exclusively serves as a guide to any aspiring entrepreneur and helps motivate them to export commodities from the state. I again extend my hearty congratulations to the Honorable Chief Minister Ji and the dedicated team who have so wonderfully organized this event. I am glad to know that Plex Consul has been able to contribute a part to this success. I am sure this event has brought all the industry stakeholders together. This will become a force that will propel the economy to greater heights and will help in providing further prosperity and economic freedom to the people in the state under the able guidance of our dynamic Sri Y.S. Jagan Mohan Ji Reddy. It will also contribute significantly to the country's exports, which is targeting exports of $400 billion under the able leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi Ji. Thank you once again, and wishing delegates, exhibitors and others all the very best. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Goenka, and to Plex Consul for being a partner, Export Council, and for their presence and participation this year. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now going to witness the release of the State Export Action Plan, which is a compilation of all the 13 district action plans. May I request our Honorable Chief Minister to kindly step forward and do the honors of releasing the State Export Action Plan. Andhra Pradesh, being the gateway to the East, is keen in developing strategies for export-led industrialization, and the main objective of the strategy is to increase value addition in export commodities, diversify our export basket, and improve quality of goods exported. The State Export Action Plan is going to be a roadmap for all our exporters. A huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, as our Honorable Chief Minister releases the State Export Action Plan, a roadmap for all our exporters, and as all our dignitaries hold a copy, here's taking a moment for a quick photo opportunity. Thank you to our Honorable CM for doing the honors. In the same line of thought, I would also request our Honorable Chief Minister to officially launch the Export Trade Portal, an e-commerce platform created by the Government of Andhra Pradesh for the purpose of enabling the exporters and importers with all the trade and export data. It is also designed to handhold MSMEs and encourage them to explore export opportunities. It will also serve as a bridge between international buyers and Indian suppliers, exporters and manufacturers. Thank you, sir, for doing the honors, and we're going to take one more moment from you. We would like our Honorable Chief Ministers has always seen the vision of industrial growth through MSMEs, and in line with the same, we are going to launch the business advisory services for small and medium entrepreneurs who intend to start their businesses in AP. Telling them where, when, how they can start their business. More than 4,000 project profiles form part of this under the auspices of YSR Business Advisory Services. Thank you very much, sir, for doing the honors. And now may I invite Padmashri BVR Mohan Reddy Garu, founder, chairman, and board member, Scient, to address the audience.
Honorable Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, honorable ministers, Chief Secretary to Government of Andhra Pradesh, members of Parliament, several dignitaries who are on the dais and off the dais. We all assemble here together as a part of the 75 years of Indian independence celebrations. 75 years, we all need to rejoice. 75 years of happiness. I've been very fortunate. I lived most of these 75 years. And I've seen an enormous amount of transformation that has happened to this nation. We waited in lines to get a train ticket for me to travel to Bangalore to Hyderabad. We used to take almost a day to get a reservation done. We waited to buy a car for 8 years to 12 years after making a 100% down payment. We waited to get a telephone for countless numbers of years. Enormous amount of transformation that we have seen. We owe it to our political leadership. We owe it to the current generation of chief ministers, like our chief minister, Mr. Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu. Our political leadership, I see several of the ministers here, and many more behind them to bring this prosperity to us. What has happened to this nation is with the ability of the political leadership to have a vision, to ensure that they had the dynamism and executed it flawlessly thereafter, made sure that there was an economic upliftment for all of us. And we started not only having economic upliftment, we started enjoying lots of benefits. So certainly the government went ahead and made sure that they created the infrastructure. They made sure that they created the policy framework. They provided us with incentives. And that's the reason why what the industry is today and what we are today as a society. So on behalf of the industry, I represented NASSCOM, I represented CII, I represented many more industries. A big thank you on behalf of the industry to the government and especially to our Chief Minister, Shri Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu. So join your hands to thank them for what all they have done for giving us an opportunity to celebrate this 75 years of glory of India. Now that I have this forum, I just have three things to bring to the attention of the Honorable Chief Minister Garu. So three things which are very dear to me of the recent past. I build business all right, but what I spend more of my time is on education, skills, entrepreneurship, and startups. On education again, let me start there. I'd like to congratulate the Honorable Chief Minister Garu. Sir, this has been one of the most progressive states in terms of reforms you have been doing it. I'm saying this from the bottom of my heart. Honestly, I'm saying this. Whether it is Nadu, Nedu, Ammavadi, refurbishing the 1,500 schools at the first phase, including the last Tuesday, he went ahead and launched the high-end skills university. And then there's a skills unit in Vizag and a skills university in Tirupati. I think these are amazing initiatives because, very honestly, political leadership does not look at education as seriously as Mr. Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu does, for the simple reason that it doesn't give them immediate benefits. Reflects back to say, here is a chief minister who has a long-term vision. He thinks in terms of a longer term, in terms of prosperity for this state and this nation. Sir, my only submission to the Honorable Minister is, we have to implement it quickly. Sir, I dabble around quite a bit on skills. If you look at skills of today are no longer going to be valid for the 21st century. The first two decades of 21st century itself, we saw that this nation is lagging behind. In some of the advanced skills like artificial intelligence, machine learning, augmented reality, blockchain, or additive manufacturing, today the shortage is a ratio of 1:8. For every 8 jobs, we just have one person to fulfill it. That's creating chaos because there is a fairly large amount of attrition in the industry. There's also an increase in salaries. So my request and honorable a submission to the Honorable Chief Minister Garu is to speed it up. It has to be not just the 30 colleges in every parliamentary constituency of Andhra Pradesh. Every college, every technical college that we have in this state of Andhra Pradesh, we should definitely ensure that we move forward with it. My second submission to the Honorable Chief Minister is certainly, yes, this country enjoys, as we speak at this point of time, especially for the last 10 years or so, something the sociologists call it as the demographic dividend. It's basically the percentage of people who are the age group of 16 to 60 are higher than the percentage of people on the other bracket, which means they're more productive workforce in the nation itself. India enjoys this. But if these people we have to be definitely good use and make them absolutely beneficial to the nation, we need to make sure not only that they're educated or combined with skills, but equally and importantly, they have to get jobs. And job creation is the biggest challenge that we have. And jobs will not come any longer from large multinationals, especially after these 18 months of pandemic. What we have seen as global trend is people are looking inward. So therefore, you have to also look at the possibility of growing more amount of entrepreneurship. Sir, my recommendation and request to you is we should mandate every engineering college in the state of Andhra Pradesh to have an incubator cell, an associated entrepreneurial ecosystem to make sure more amount of entrepreneurs come out. It is entrepreneurs don't create big jobs. They're all small companies. But look at the sum total of the number of entrepreneurs and multiply them with the jobs that they make. They are in hundreds of thousands. So therefore, I think the second submission I have for the Honorable Minister is about entrepreneurship ecosystem creation. Promotion, I'm sure there are a number of initiatives that his government is already doing, but we need to do it a little more. My last one in the list is Honorable Gautam Reddy Garu also talked about Atmanirbhar Bharat, self-sufficient India, inward-looking India. We want to become stronger. Andhra Pradesh also wants to become stronger. We want to bring about more amount of research and development. There are a number of research institutions already here. I'm not suggesting that we pour more money into research. My only suggestion is research cannot be a one-way street. It has to be a two-way street. We put money into research, but research should give us very productive effort. They should give us good products. They should give us new processes. They should have inventions. Those should be marketed and they should be marketable. So the third submission is we should create an institution, like it's been done in a few other places that I'm aware of, where we are trying to pull out all the research that's being done within a state to ensure that it becomes monetizable. So these are the three submissions I have for the Honorable Chief Minister and the rest of the people here today. I'd like to also use this opportunity finally to thank APISC, Mr. Subramaniam and his team, especially taking this initiative of today celebrating Vanidya Utsavam. So it's basically celebrating trade and industry, recognizing the importance of trade and industry to APISE. A big thank you. Again, thank you for listening to me. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Sri BVR Mohan Reddy Garu, for your submissions. I'm sure your experience and expertise will definitely be considered and cherished. Ladies and gentlemen, it's now the moment that we've been waiting for. I request our Honorable Chief Minister to deliver his inaugural address.
Respected members of the High Commissions of various countries, entrepreneurs and exporters, members from various Export Promotion Council, representatives of Government of India who are taking part in this event, my cabinet colleagues, officials of the state government and various other stakeholders. I extend a very warm welcome to all of you here. In fact, this is the beginning of Vanijya Utsavam, that is Trade Carnival. 2 days of this event will be conducted here, and then another 4 days in the various districts as well. So this whole week is supposed to bring trade closer to the government, and also that government also moves closer to the trade. This whole week is supposed to bring that objective. Commemorating Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, that is the 75th year of the nation's independence, we commence this Vanijya Utsavam. In fact, if one were to look at the past 2 years that have passed, in fact, we would come across overwhelming challenges which have been imposed by legacy issues, a year of economic downturn, and another year of outbreak of COVID-19 pandemic. In fact, during the course of these 2 years, it was probably the first time during the last two decades wherein the country has seen a contraction of 3.38% in gross tax revenue collections. In fact, the country's gross tax revenue collections declined from 20,80,465 crores during the period 2018-19 to 20,10,059 crores during the year 2019-20. In fact, these were challenging times. The country's GDP growth in constant terms was 6.3% during the year 2018-19. Dropped to 4% during the year 2019-20. Further dropped to -7.3% during the year 2020-21.
In fact, India's exports have also shrunk by, in fact, 11.6%, from $330 billion to $292 billion over the last two financial years. In fact, this was the plight of the country during the course of these last 2 years. Yet, in these difficult times, Andhra Pradesh exports have grown by 19.4%. From $14.1 billion to $16.8 billion. In fact, through a combination of various products, marine products contributed 15%, ship and boat building structures have contributed 8.5%, pharma contributed 7.3%, iron and steel contributed 7.3%, and non-basmati rice as well contributed 4.8%. All this culminating into a jump of 19.4%, leading to an improvement in the state's contribution to exports from the ninth position that we were in 2018-19 to seventh position in 2019-20 and to the fourth position now in 2020-21. And while our GSDP were also to be compared to the national parameters, then while our GSDP contraction in our GSDP was only 2.58% in the COVID year 2020-21, when compared to the country's contraction of 7.3% in terms of GDP at constant prices for the year 2020-21. In fact, why I've been wanting to stress on these parameters is the performance stands testimony to our belief that right infrastructure and enabling policies, these two are very, very important. In fact, they become the cornerstones for industrial development in growth and augmentation of exports. In fact, in these last 2 years, we have moved a long way. In the last 2 years alone, 16,311 MSMEs were established with an investment of 5,204 crores, generating employment opportunities for more than 1,13,777 people. During the course of these last 2 years, apart from this, 68 large and mega industries have been facilitated to commence production, bringing an investment of rupees 30,175 crores and generating an employment opportunities for 46,119 people. Apart from this, 62 large and mega projects are under active implementation with a total investment of 36,384 crores, with an employment potential of 76,916 people. In the last 1 year alone, we have approved 10 mega projects with an investment intent of 26,391 crores with an employment potential of 55,024 crores. With an employment potential of 55,024 people. Our state is the only state in the country to have to go in for development of three industrial corridors. Visakhapatnam to Chennai industrial corridor, Chennai to Bangalore industrial corridor, and Hyderabad to Bangalore industrial corridor. These three corridors will facilitate accelerated development across the state. It will push economic growth, industrialization in a big way. The state government is also developing a mega industrial hub in Kopparthi. In fact, in my own district, Kadapa, YSR Kadapa district. The reason why I say it is my own district is because I'm tagging my name to it. So there would be results. With an extent of 3,155 acres, the hub will act as a multi-product mega industrial park. With best-in-class infrastructure facilities like power, water, CETPs, STPs, and is likely to bring in an investment of 25,000 crores with the potential to generate employment opportunities for more than 1 lakh of people. In the same facility, Kopparthi, we are also developing an electronic manufacturing cluster, EMC, in another 800 acres with an investment of around about 730 crores. This electronic manufacturing cluster will attract an anticipated investment of 10,000 crores with the potential to create large-scale employment to about 25,000 people there. Keeping in mind the surging global and domestic demand for steel also in mind, we are also going ahead with a 3 million ton per annum greenfield steel plant in Kadapa district as well, with an outlay of 13,500 crores. We are of the firm view that for sustainable industrial development, availability of gas as an energy source is of vital importance. Therefore, in partnership with GAIL, we are developing a gas distribution network to secure availability of gas for both industrial and domestic purposes. This would go a long way in not only bringing down the carbon footprint, but also making energy source available at cheaper, in a cheaper way. Going further, to reduce the skill gap, we are establishing 26 world-class skill colleges, one in every parliament constituency, with one skill university as well, in Tirupati, and one more skill university in Visakhapatnam. This will cater to the needs of both IT-related courses as well as manufacturing-related courses. This will reduce the skill gap as these skill colleges will provide for polishing the skills. This will actually help in polishing the skills of those people who have already graduated, who already have a degree. Those degrees would be polished towards job orientation. In fact, Andhra Pradesh currently contributes to 5.8% of national exports, and we aspire to double this capacity to 10% by the year 2030. This is the dream with which we are moving ahead. And to attain this goal, we have formulated a comprehensive roadmap. Given the 974-kilometer coastline of the state of Andhra Pradesh, which has the potential to demonstrate substantial growth in exports, the state government is going ahead with the development of 3 more ports in the government sector. One of the ports is going to be coming up in Bavanpadu in Srikakulam district, another in Ramayapatnam, bordering Prakasam and Ellore, and another in Machilipatnam in this Krishna district as well. Given the proximity of these 3 ports to the neighboring states, the Machilipatnam port is the closest to Telangana, Ramayapatnam is the closest to Tamil Nadu, Bavanpadu is the closest state to the entire north. So given the proximity of these ports to the neighboring states, these ports would also contribute significantly to India's foreign trade growth and promote port-led industrialization in a very, very big way. The current port capacity in the state of Andhra Pradesh is 254 million tons per annum. And with the development of these 3 new ports, the capacity would be increased by another 65 million tons per annum in the first phase. To capture the benefits of value addition, because value addition also helps in exports. So to capture the benefits of value addition, the state government is setting up 25 secondary food processing units in each of the parliamentary constituencies. This would not only help the farmers in supporting their prices, but would also lead to a value addition which would increase our exports. This has the potential to create an employment directly to 30,000 people and an indirect employment of another 50,000 people. We are also developing 8 new fishing harbors. In fact, before this concept was thought about, we had a situation where our fishermen were going all the way to Gujarat. I mean, in fact, why is it that we have such a big coastline and yet our fishermen do not have the harbors here in Andhra Pradesh? So we wanted to change that. And so we are developing 8 new fishing harbors in 2 phases with an outlay of 3,827 crores of investment. These facilities will directly benefit 76,230 fishermen and will generate additional employment opportunities for another 35,000 individuals and will create a whole lot of allied sector opportunities, be it the ice plants, the cold storages, the pre-processing, fish transport and marketing. This would also help to better these products. More processing would help in more exports. I wish to conclude by conveying my deepest sense of appreciation for the commitment shown by the manufacturers, shown by the exporters, councils, and workforce alike in staying resilient during these tough times that have passed. Now, this year, hopefully the economy is buoyant, and we'd see more positive results. I also congratulate each of the stakeholders for coming together in this Vanijya Utsavam, a crucial step in the right direction to explore wider avenues and collaborations organized together with the support of the central government. And I'm sure that this initiative today will boost confidence in the entrepreneurs, will encourage more number of people to come to Andhra Pradesh, to grow with Andhra Pradesh, as our Chief Secretary some time back did say. So I wish you all a very warm welcome. And any support that you require of us, we're all available. In fact, we have a very proactive minister as well, who's just spoken some time back. He's one of the very few ministers who's very, very proactive when it comes to trade. So hopefully, all these initiatives would go a long way. And anything that we can do, you may suggest, and we will ensure that we will do the best to incorporate those suggestions so as to make it more friendly. Thank you.
Thank you very much, our Honorable Chief Minister. Growth of exports by 19.4%, development of three industrial corridors, EMCs, proactive government and its policies, generation of employment, skilled education. There is so much that all of us can look forward to and participate in and with this government to make Andhra Pradesh a truly rising economic force. Thank you once again, sir. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's the moment where we honor and felicitate our industry champions and export champions. Allow me to share a little bit about them. Industrial development in the state is being facilitated by proactive administration and transparent governance. Under the dynamic leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister, marquee companies across the globe have made the state their home due to its very advantage. We would like to recognize the efforts of some of these companies in taking the state and its population forward. Ladies and gentlemen, please join our hands together as the first Industry Champion Award goes to none other than Padma Shri Shri BVR Mohan Reddy, Executive Chairman, Cyient Limited. May I request our Honorable Chief Minister to do the honors of presenting Mohan Reddy, sir, with the Industry Champion Award. I beg your pardon, Dr. BVR Mohan Reddy has also been the past chairman of CII Southern Region. A huge round of applause for him, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations, sir. The next Industry Champion Award goes to Mr. Cab Dong Lee, Chief Administrative Officer, Kia India Private Limited. Congratulations, sir. The next Industry Champion is Sri Anil Chalamasetti, Managing Director, Greenco Energies Private Limited. A huge round of applause for him, ladies and gentlemen. Up next, Sri Avinash Chand Rai, Chief Executive Officer, Adani Krishnapatnam Port, and Mr. G.J. Rao, Director, Adani Krishnapatnam Port. Can we invite both of them to receive the Industry Champions Award? Can we please give them a huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen? Moving ahead, the next industry champion is Mr. Ishan Reddy Ala, Promoter Director, Ramki Group. Can we please give him a huge round of applause? Mr. Ishan Reddy Ala, Promoter Director, Ramki Group. Congratulations, sir. Moving ahead, the next industry champion is Mr. C.V. Rajulu, Vice President, NACL Industries Limited. Come on, ladies and gentlemen, we can do better than this. Please put your hands together. These are the industry champions and we are felicitating them today. Our next industry champion is Mr. K. Madan Mohan Reddy, Executive Director, Aurobindo Pharma Limited. Mr. K. Madan Mohan Reddy, congratulations, sir. From industry champions, let's shift our gaze to export champions. The state of Andhra Pradesh exported goods worth 16.8 billion USD, which is 5.8% of the total Indian exports. The top 10 export categories contributed 55% of the state export value. The state has identified export champions who have contributed immensely despite and in spite of the pandemic. We are here to acknowledge their efforts and contribution, ladies and gentlemen. Our first export champion, Mr. C. Sarvanand, Chief Operating Officer, Brandex India Apparel Private Limited. Can we please have a huge round of applause for him? Congratulations, sir. And as he receives this award, allow me to move forward and share with you our next export champion, Mr. Lee Yee See, General Manager, Apache Footwear India Private Limited. Congratulations, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, can we have a huge round of applause for Mr. Lee Yee See, General Manager, Apache Footwear India Private Limited, our export champion. Up next, Mr. B.V. Krishna Rao, Managing Director, Patabhi Agro Foods Private Limited. Congratulations, Mr. B.V. Krishna Rao. And as he receives his award, our next export champion whom I'd like to invite is Srimati Vanka Rajakumari, Managing Director, Indian Hair Industries Private Limited. Srimati Vanka Rajakumari, can we please have a huge round of applause for the lady, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Pandava Prasad, General Manager, SNF India Private Limited, our next export champion. Mr. Pandava Prasad, General Manager, SNF India Private Limited. Congratulations, sir. And our next export champion, Mrs. Singaluri Sarada Devi, partner, RV Corp. Congratulations, ma'am. Can we please have a huge round of applause for Mrs. Singaluri Sarada Devi, ladies and gentlemen. What a thrilling moment for all the industry champions and export champions to be felicitated and recognized by the government of Andhra Pradesh. Thank you, sir, for doing the honors. Thank you to all our dignitaries. And ladies and gentlemen, moving forward, the last leg of the inaugural event, may I request Srimati Poonam Malakondaya, IAS, Special Chief Secretary to Government, Agriculture, Horticulture, Fisheries and Sugar Government of Andhra Pradesh to propose the word of thanks.
Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, Honorable Ministers, Industry Stalwarts, Bureaucrats, Respected Chief Secretary, Foreign Embassy Representatives, Industry Leaders, Associations, I feel honored and privileged to get the opportunity to propose a word of thanks on this special day at the Vanijya Utsam at the State and Trade and Exports Carnival of State of Andhra Pradesh. On behalf of State of Government of Andhra Pradesh, I would like to wholeheartedly express my deepest appreciation and profound gratitude towards Honorable Chief Minister Sir, Sri Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu for gracing the occasion and sharing his vision with us for the State of Andhra Pradesh. Sir, your last address on 3rd September 2021 to the citizens of Andhra Pradesh and officials of the state government on industrial policy progress in the state of Andhra Pradesh over past 2 years and releasing incentives to support the MSMEs and textile sector is a testament to your commitment to the state's development agenda, this will surely go a long way in boosting the investor confidence in the state to achieve the targets. Sir, your commitment to better the lives of farmers of the state and to keep them at the center of food processing policy of the state is a path-breaking initiative in this country and will be of great support to enterprising farmers of the state and will bring value to their produce and better expertise and value and economies to their lives. Sir, it is with pride I say that due to these enabling policies of our dynamic Honorable Chief Minister, it has furthered the export of agri and horticulture, not only in volume, but also in value, and also the marine exports, in particularly in areas of chili, rice, shrimp, prawn, fruits and vegetables, despite the pandemic situation. I take this opportunity to also extend my gratitude to the Honorable Minister for Industries, Commerce, IT and Skill Development, Shri Mekapati Gautam Reddy Garu, for his continuous engagement and encouragement and guidance in conduct of these 2 days program, today and tomorrow, and over the week at the District Industry Center, which will act as a curtain raiser to achieve the targets of doubling the exports set by our Honorable Chief Minister for the state of Andhra Pradesh by 2030. I also take this opportunity to express my gratitude to Honorable Minister for Agriculture, Cooperation, Marketing and Food Processing, Shri Kurisala Kanna Babu Garu, who will be leading the discussions tomorrow on furthering the export opportunities in agri-commodities, marine products and food processing. My special thanks to departments from Government of India, Department of Commerce, Director General of Foreign Trade, districts as exports hub, Agriculture and Processed Food Product Export Development Authority, Marine Products Export Development Authority, officials from exports-related institutions such as Exim Bank, Export Credit Guarantee Corporation of India, and the Container Corporation of India. As you would all appreciate, there is a huge potential of Andhra Pradesh for the exports in agri and other sectors, and also there is also a very, very positive policy support from the state of Andhra Pradesh under the dynamic leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister. Your esteemed presence will certainly win confidence of the exporters from the state to work more closely with the line departments and expand the trade avenues aligned with the vision of our Honorable Chief Minister. I commend the untiring efforts of officials from various state governments, Department of Industries and Commerce, Export Promotion, Andhra Pradesh Trade Promotion Corporation, APEDB, Agriculture, Horticulture, Fisheries, Animal Husbandry Departments, and the Andhra Pradesh Industrial Infrastructure Corporation. Lastly, I would also congratulate the industry champions and the best exporters across the state. This marks your contribution to the industrial growth of the state and shall inspire many others to become brand ambassadors of this potential state to the globe. Let me conclude this brief intervention on behalf of the Government of Andhra Pradesh with a deep appreciation for the overwhelming response from the exporters, manufacturers, export promotion councils, industry associations, and trade bodies to participate in this conference. Thank you all very much.
Thank you very much, ma'am, and our gratitude to our Honorable Chief Minister and all the other dignitaries for joining us for the inaugural session of the Vanijya Utsavam 2021. With that, we come to the end of the inaugural session, ladies and gentlemen. Please join us for lunch. It's being served in the foyer area outside. It's 12:20 by my clock. Please reassemble back in the hall by 1:50 p.m. where we begin with our second session for the day, Produce Local, Go Global. I repeat, please reassemble in the hall by 1:50 p.m. for our second session for the day, Produce Local, Go Global. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please enjoy your lunch.
Subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button. Click the bell button and enjoy the latest uploads from our channel.